Do you have any practices that you do? Do you, for example, do intermittent fasting or any type of fasting or time-restricted eating? Or?
Usually, in my ordinary life, when I'm in Paris and work, I only have one meal per day. So I have dinner with cheese and wine containing spermidine and resveratrol. It's an ideal combination because inhibiting the acetyltransferase and activating the deacetylase will have, of course, a synergistic effect.
Oh, they do.
Well, you can show this in mice, and okay. This is an excuse for me to profit from a very good combination. I do also practice some fasting twice per year or so when I don't eat anything for 5 days.
Oh, wow. Yeah. So you do a prolonged fast twice a year?
Well, it's not so prolonged. So you know that Gandhi, for instance, has been doing fasting exercises for 20 days or more, which is the time at which a normal individual could have some long-term consequences on the health. So 20 days is a period that usually could be easily supported by a healthy middle-aged individual that has no underlying pathologies.
Mm-hmm. I have a couple of friends that have done, one of them is used a lot, very prolonged fast, like 20 days. He's morbidly obese and he's lost now like 200 pounds over the course of a year by doing just several rounds of these prolonged fasts. But he's got a lot of fat, you know, to supply energy. I'm not sure I would subject myself to a 20-day water fast, but it's cool to know that you do these 5-day water fasts twice a year and eating one meal a day.
Doing exercise.
And when you're eating, throughout the day, when you're not eating, do you drink coffee?
Yes.
Your coffee. Yeah. And there's polyphenols in coffee that actually...
Yes, we published a study in mice, giving them a non-toxic dose of caffeinated or decaffeinated coffee with the drinking water continuously. And we could show that this was magnificently inducing autophagy.
Yeah,
in a caffeine-independent fashion.
Right, totally independent of caffeine, yeah. So just the polyphenols. Mm. And this was like, I think I read your study, it was like after 4 hours or something in the mice.
Yeah.
So in humans, potentially maybe the fasting plus the coffee.
Well, coffee abuse has been linked to major health-promoting effects. Most cardiovascular and neurodegenerative diseases are actually reduced in heavy coffee drinkers as an independent link between lifestyle and pathology. So, of course, it's an association. It always can be criticized because it's just a study in which you find a statistical correlation. Okay. It would be much more interesting to do a randomized clinical trial on coffee intake.
Yeah. More interesting and more expensive, yeah.
Absolutely.
So, great. So, fasting, coffee, wine and cheese, one meal, exercise, you're doing it all. Mm. Awesome.